is back. That's one. You know, there's a lot I can say, but before we do anything, let's not get too excited. My name is Cinder. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. It's a Friday for all of you who don't know what time it is. It's going to be turn up day. All the way, I think today is when almost every company in Uganda is throwing their Christmas party. Bananke. Don't drink with caution. Your bosses haven't been kind to you during the course of the year. Drink there. My name is Diaz Onasi. Well, I'm just saying. But besides that, let's see what's happening in Celebrityville with... so much is happening. I'm just saying. Okay, so Leila Kayondo is finally back. Yes! I have been waiting for this opportune moment to look this chick straight in the eye and try to jog her mind on what she thinks. Now, first of all, Leila has upgraded from the Mbuga accent, baby. This girl came back and she sounded more British than I'd even ever heard. She sounded Cockney to me. No, you know you can be British, but you're speaking Cockney. This, Leila, my goodness. The chick, and I was like, wait, where did this chick go? They're like Boston, US of A. Why does she sound British? We don't pretty much know. Leila Kayondo, my dear love. Now, before I even show you what she had to say, Leila has this whole thing about her. She was trying to tell us, I was tired, I had jet lag, you know. Leila, now, according to you, the one-on-one that we heard, you went and you told us, no, I because we asked you, why did you just leave? You just left when SK's wedding was just, you know, at the verge of everything. She's like, no, you don't understand it. You don't. Oh, I have to use her accent. You don't understand it. Like, I heard about his wedding when I was abroad. Leila Kayondo, you girl from Rakai, why are you lying to us? Just 3 weeks before this party even came, you were around town asking and soliciting for dimes to go and go to Boston. Don't forget, I told you. I have the receipts of how you went to Boston. And secondly, why are you trying to play dumb and you're all there like, you know, but I'm so happy for them. I'm happy for SK and Vivian, you know, SK is my friend. We're like,
So it was a coincidence that one of my friends was wedding a city wall. Yes. I'm happy for them. Yeah, I got to know when I was in Boston. Yeah? And then but I'm happy for them, you know. Marriage is God sent. Katunda Yabi organizing, I know human beings. I am happy, I'm concentrating on myself. People take being single as a bad thing, but me, I take it as a good thing because you get to love each other, learn about yourself, because you're not really looking at concentrating on what someone else is telling you. So I think it's a good feeling. I'm happy, I'm not complaining.
I have no idea, but here's the thing. We get it. You and SK are still banging on the side, given the fact that Vivian is not a wife only, she's a partner in crime. But embrace your newfound, how should I call it? I'm looking for the right word, because you see, you're not a career woman. You have not much going for you, so embrace the fact that they made you the official side dish. It's not so bad. I mean, where would you have gone with feet like yours? Still talking about SK's situation. Yes, we have not yet finished with it, but this time we don't care much for SK. I hear SK has a... He's going to have a reality show. Lord have mercy. I mean, what is going to be on that reality show? A lot of Luganda, a lot of Vivian's fake accent. Meanwhile, can someone explain to me where Vivian got the accent from? Because as far as I'm concerned, Vivian is pretty much a South African chick stroke UEA stroke. I don't... We all know that Auntie Sylvia Worry decided to be the everything of this wedding. She was the wedding planner, and from the jump when this wedding was going on, I kept telling people, Sylvia Bagendo Muku baby konde. So people have come out. Apparently Mona Faces and a couple of service providers are like, Mrs. Sylvia, the wedding, the 3 billion wedding or 2 billion wedding, yes, it's done. Can you please pay us? And she's like, I paid everyone. I did. I honestly did. Really, Sylvia? Really? But we take you to court. We can't even take you to court. We know where to take you. But that's beside it. I thought about the fact that the SKs are now probably on a double, triple honeymoon somewhere. And they're coming up with a reality TV show. And the very first thing that I ask myself is, a look into that reality TV show. What would it be like? Vivian would be all over the place speaking in her fake accent, because I don't quite understand how genuine that accent is. I don't. I was listening to her wedding speech. I was like, I can't quite place you. Where are you from, boo boo? Because last time I checked, you were a chick who was based in South Africa, in Dubai, in Oman. Where do you get that accent from? Okay, it's better than Leila Kayondo's fake English, because you can at least speak English. What is SK Mbuga going to be doing in that entire show? Is he just going to walk around and show us house? Imagine SK Mbuga in his boxers. I mean, that's reality for you. Right. Let's wait and see. Other than that, Sylvia Warris, as soon as I want to send us out, stop pretending like you care so much about the image of the Eskers. You stole that money. We need that money. The wedding wasn't really up to par because of your stealing antics. Yeah, yes, I did. I think I did. There's something that pissed me off today. I've been hearing it for a while, and I'm like, really, Ugandans, why are we so petty? I mean, I'm the queen of petty, but certain things just piss me off. So apparently, the late AK-47's widow, that is, of course, Nalongo, it's what we call her, is under so much public humiliation, catcalling, people are calling her names. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, clear as throat. Why do we care about this chick? She moved on. She let us go. Now, the letters that Uganda is calling a scandal, they finally found out that Nalongo has kids who are not SKs, who are rather SK. My goodness, SK is stuck in my mind. Anyway, Nalongo has other kids. They were not AK-47's kids. And the fact that she hid them from the public because she was dating AK, not the other people, she decided to keep her kids away, and all of you people are looking at her like, oh my goodness, that chick, she wasn't loyal. Maybe even Eka didn't know about those kids. Of what business is it to you? This is Kampala, Uganda. Not even just Uganda, this is Africa. So imagine, you wanted what? You think everyone is going to pull a Zari? Zari is one of those chicks who doesn't really care, you know? She'll come out and she'll tell you, I have 5 kids with this guy, 10 with this one, I'm giving you 5. She has no problem. But if Nalongo felt she didn't have to let us know about her kids, why should we care much? I mean, really? I have a feeling that AK-47 knew what he was getting himself into, because let's not fake it. I mean, we're not supposed to talk ill of the dead, but AK was one of those guys. His funeral was just an eye-opener, honestly speaking. There were like about 10 different girls who are claiming to be his chani. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, ah! This one wanted to fall in, the other one was crying, the other one was looking for Wiyambi. I think AK-47 knew what he was getting himself into when he decided to date this Nalongo chick. And let's not forget, his biggest motivation was always money. So just let it be. Let's just let this one, you know, let it ride out. AK is resting in peace. Nalongo is moving on with her life. Just shut up. Go kick rocks. Walk off short cliffs. Ugandans, can you please? Next thing you know is that Emayanja is also going to come out and she's like, yeah, oyo mukazi twaba gamba. If I hear that, I am going to shoot someone, I swear. So Ugandans are still pissed off. I hear Wizkid Banangu Msaja, he broke our hearts, he didn't show up, hey! I have news for you. So he came out and he said the doctors told him not to show up. He's not going to be doing that much traveling. He's not going to be doing concerts this entire year, which is pretty much like 3 weeks left. But here's the thing. Do you Ugandans actually think Wizkid cares about you? Because I just realized Wizkid just got nominated for a Grammy Award, people. Grammy Award! And you think he's going to walk away from LA to come and sing in a third world country that he pretty much doesn't care about? He is getting 2 Grammy nods. Now, if he is lucky, here's the thing. You know that song, One Dance, with Drake? Well, he contributed a lot. Now, the most recent is Drake is being nominated. He has been nominated for One Dance, the full album. And if he takes ABBA Album of the Year, guess what? Wizkid is entitled to 2 Grammys, because as of now, they're changing it. If you have Album of the Year, your persons who are featured on that album, the biggest contributors, get a Grammy. Your studio mixer gets a Grammy. Your sound mixer gets a Grammy. So he could literally walk away with 2 Grammy Awards, and you think he would care about us? I just felt played, like, all the way, but it's just what it is. When you're big, you're big. Okay, that's just about it. It's been my time. Catch me again on Monday. But for now, though, you can always go to our Twitter page, or my Twitter page. That's, of course, at TinaFierce1. Or you can catch us on YouTube in case you missed an episode. We are airing, yes, a 10:20 on Living from Monday to Friday in the night. I know you'll all been asking the same question. But besides that, our Facebook page is also open to you. You can always leave your suggestions, drop your lugambo, drop your hints. We'll get to it. For now, though, I'm out.